Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. So, like I promised in the last part, I figured I'd show you a couple of these monsters and how strong they are compared to what we've been facing in the previous levels. Like, for example, this giant fire, which is, I would say, the worst one in the level, but if you want to know how bad, have a look. I am at 169,000 hit points. And now I am at zero. So clearly these are not creatures you want to mess with. And as you can see, I also can barely damage them, so there's really no way to take them out with your melee weapon at this stage. Okay, spine demons we've seen before, so I'll skip those. Okay, more fires. We already know those are too strong for us. As you can see, my mantle is still a little bit active, so I'm using that a bit. Where's that guy I wanted to kill? See, they're all over the place when you don't want them, but when you do want them, you won't be able to find them. Ah, mantle's worked. It's magic. More spine devils. Yep, we've seen you guys already. Come on, get out of my way. Oh, there. It's behind the stupid wall, of course. Oh, can't go this way either. Ah, here's a good one. Oops. Damn it. Okay, you know what? Since this is just a little trial anyway, I'm just gonna waste some items to get out of here. Come on, monsters, where are you? Ah, there's one. Yeah, these Kamzots, as I was talking about them earlier, they're nowhere near as strong as the Fire Elemental. You can actually take these out with your melee weapon if you put some effort into it, but they're still pretty dangerous. As you can see with our magic, they're pretty easy to deal with, but once you start attacking them, 60, 40, 60, quite heavy damage. As you can see, we're almost dead from pretty much full hit points, so definitely a scary enemy. Also, as you can see, our red potion will now instantly take us to max thanks to our much higher wisdom and, of course, experience with the potion as well. These guys are also pretty tough. These are a little bit easier to avoid because they don't have an aggressive movement pattern, or at least these ones did. I think some of the other incarnations do. But again, 40,000, 60,000, 70,000 hit points damage per hit is nothing to sneeze at. What else? I'm sure there's more. They were crawling all over the place before and now I can't find them. Okay, well, these shamblings, yeah. Similar to before, they will easily do 40,000, 30,000 hit points per hit. So, again, pretty powerful. Not as powerful as some of the other ones, but still pretty scary. What I really wanted to find were those wyverns, those red flying ones that you saw passing by earlier. Because those are basically the most important ones in this level. You wanna... Ah, there he is. Okay, we're chasing you now. There we go. Now these are the guys you really want to use your melee attacks on because they... Not in the first spawn, but in the later spawns, they can drop elixirs. Which obviously makes any amount of damage they give you somewhat worthwhile, at least, unless they kill you. And again, they are not terribly aggressive, so you can hit them from the side if you time it right. And even the earlier spawns give stuff like hourglasses and stuff, so they are definitely worth killing. The giant fires also drop some nice items, I believe, so you might want to save those for later when you're a bit stronger. Okay, so the second spawn. As you can see, still very high damage, so be very careful. It's very easy to die, even if you just stop paying attention for a second. Like I did just now, so even if you are going to kill them with your weapon, it's advisable to at least get rid of a couple of them with your magic attacks. Now, I found a Japanese website. See, again. Just, and I wasn't even being hit from the side or from behind this time. It's just this guy that I was trying to kill. So yeah, what I was saying is, I found this Japanese website which actually lists every single monster type, all their different spawns, the amount of damage they do, that sort of thing. So I'll put a link in this video to show you where to find that. It also has maps for all the towers, but they're a little bit hard to read, so I don't know how useful those are. Again, clearly a lot of damage for limited results. So yeah, be very careful on this level about fighting these monsters, because they are no pushovers. They are definitely very powerful. And unfortunately, because we cannot upgrade our armor anymore except through what we find in towers, and as you can see, there's, I don't think there's any armor to be found in these level 8 towers. So that pretty much means you are screwed in this level. Unless, of course, just like before, you want to equip something like, I don't know, an hourglass or a demon's ring. Let's go with a demon's ring. Flew away again. Using, of course, those kinds of items means you will not be taking any damage at all, and you will be able to kill them easily. Demon's ring. There we go. And of course, now with our high wisdom as well, the demon's ring will last for quite a long time, which means that we will be able to kill many monsters with a single demon's ring. So if you position yourself right, and if you time it right, you can actually use this to build up your fighter experience and pick up a bunch of good items, which is my advice for this level. Use items to kill the monsters, and in fact the subsequent levels as well. Once we get to level 9 and 10, things are not getting easier, they are only getting harder. Which of course makes perfect sense. So you see, our demon's ring is still active after all this time, so we can still kill a lot of these critters. And as far as I know, this is the only proper way to still be in melee combat in this level. Of course, you could just switch to complete the magic attacks only, but it's easier to level up on two sides than it is to level up on one, because of course your required amount of experience rises much quicker on the if you just focus on one side instead of on both of them. So yeah, my little 2 cents for how to get through level 7 with good experience and good items. Okay guys, thanks for watching. I think I'll spend a little bit of time clearing out level 8 now, and I will meet you back when we are ready to move on to level 9. Again, thanks for watching everyone, and I will see you there.